Welcome back to Fueled by Plants. And in this video, I am going to be dispelling the myth behind coffee and showing you and telling you exactly if coffee is healthy or unhealthy for you and the benefits and the cons of coffee. Now, before we get started, if you are someone who is struggling to lose weight, lose fat, build muscle, build strength, and transform your body, I want you to click the link below right now and schedule a free consultation call with me. On that call, we are going to go over what exactly the goal and goals are that you want to accomplish. We're going to figure out what is the roadblocks and what is stopping you from actually making that dream a reality. And number three, giving you a five-step proven process that will actually help you and propel you forward into getting to your goal and helping you maintain it long term. All right. Now, let's get to the video. Plant Fuel Justin back with another video. And in this video, I am going to be telling you the pros and cons to coffee and drinking coffee. All right. Now, I have coffee right here. I love coffee. I am a coffee drinker. I am a coffee connoisseur. But the facts remain. Is coffee healthy? Is it something that you should be drinking? Or is it something bad? Because number one pro to drinking coffee is it increases performance. So what does that mean? Performance can be looked at in two different ways. Number one, cognitive ability. Also, physical ability. So number one, cognitive ability. It increases focus. It increases cognitive function. You're better at handling tasks, performing tasks, problem solving, all these different things because it helps you focus and it helps to be more diligent, all right? With the physicality, just drinking coffee 30 minutes to an hour before your workout, you actually are able to push harder for gains in the gym. It's been scientifically proven, all right? So number two is it fights disease. Coffee, the coffee bean is actually a fruit. It's called the coffea bean or coffea berry, all right? All fruits have antioxidants, okay? Free radicals in the body gets into our body due to stress, due to all different things that we encounter throughout the day, and antioxidants fight against those things, all right? And drinking coffee boosts antioxidants up tremendously. So number three is it helps with weight loss, all right? It helps with weight loss. Not only does it blunt your appetite, but also drinking coffee increases the insulin receptors and actually fights against the sugar cravings. And we all know that sugar, mostly found in carbohydrates, and most people have problems with carbohydrates. So by drinking coffee, there is a major correlation to losing fat and losing weight, all right? Now let's get to the con. The number one con, it, you know, drains the adrenal glands and taxes the adrenal glands. When you drink coffee, you get a burst of energy, but that energy is within the body and the stored energy that our body has. Now, our body is designed to keep us propelling forward, okay? So we keep energy reserves in our body, all right? What coffee does is it taps into those energy reserves and brings it out without you actually needing it, okay? And what happens is it taxes the adrenal glands. So you really want to watch your coffee intake and not overdo it because it can be very taxing in the long run, all right? Number two con is it raises LDL, which is the bad cholesterol. There's good cholesterol, bad cholesterol, all right? So drinking coffee actually raises the LDL, which is the bad cholesterol. So if you already have high cholesterol and you have a problem with that, reducing your coffee intake could be a good thing to do, all right? And number three, the effects of sleep and circadian rhythm in the body. By drinking coffee later into the day, later into the night, can actually have a bad effect on the circadian rhythm. The circadian rhythm is what your body goes on to have a great night's sleep know when it's daylight, know when it's nighttime, knows when to sleep, and knows when to be awake, all right? And if you disrupt that, it can be very detrimental to your sleep patterns, all right? So drinking coffee later into the day can be very detrimental, actually, to your sleep cycle, okay? Now, with that being said, am I telling you not to drink coffee? No. Am I telling you to drink more coffee? No. I am giving you this so you can make your own informed decision, so it can be a well-informed decision, so you're not just spinning your wheels trying to figure out, is it good, is it bad, I don't know what to do. This is an unbiased video to show you three pros, three cons, which I think coffee can be good for you, right? Just like anything, if you overdo it, it can be bad. If you don't do it, it can also be good, but it's just all depends on you, all right? So if this video was any value to you, make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. Share it with a coffee drinker that you know. Share it with a friend. Share it with a family member. Share it with someone who can benefit from this information, all right? Till next time, fuel yourself. Don't fool yourself. Peace.
Sebi, he was teaching health. I fuck with Rick Ross 'cause he teaching wealth. Drop down.